Welcome back to Overtime with the OVC. I'm your host, Jonathan Owens. We've been busy here at the conference office preparing for all the upcoming fall championships, so I have a lot to catch you up on, including in this week's episode, the 2014 cross-country preview. Find out what team is running to host the OVC soccer championships. Of course, we have a few top plays, and we will nominate the honoree of the week. So strap in, because you're in overtime. It's that time of year again that runners love best. It's not too hot, it's not too cold. The air is just right to get a good run in. All this, plus great competition, makes for an exciting weekend to look forward to at the Cross Country Championships. The best of our conference has to offer will take off on foot to determine this year's men and women's conference champions. Taking a look at our top runners in the conference, Eastern Kentucky is looking to continue the title run on both men and women's side, posting the top times thus far this season. The Colonels have built a solid cross-country program, producing top runners and polling National League among the top 30 teams consistently. A year ago, the Colonels finished 15th at the NCAA championships.
Well, we've been working all year and sort of aimed for, you know, this is the most important meet so far, and so we're tapering off somewhat, but not a whole lot this week, and hopefully we'll be prepared to be as competitive as we possibly can.
The championship hosted by UT Martin is scheduled for Saturday at Oxford Lake Park in Oxford, Alabama, with a 9 a.m. women's start and the men starting at 10:30. Be sure to check in later at ovcsports.com for all the final standings and times. The 2014 soccer season is coming to an end this Friday, which will decide the conference season champ and who hosts this year's championships. Watch top-ranked SIUE take on number 2 SEMO in our match of the week on the OVC Digital Network. SIUE needs a win or a draw to advance as season champs, but SEMO with a win will clinch the season title. Be sure to tune in to this match as well as others around the conference as the season comes to a close and teams look to secure spots in this year's OVC Soccer Championships. The month of November concludes the fall championship season with the Women's Volleyball Championships. Along with soccer, the field is narrowing for the conference season championship title. Here's a look at the current standings in the OVC. Murray has been strong all year with an 18-4 overall record, 9-1 in conference play. They currently hold the number one spot going into this weekend. Still left on their schedule, though, are the Gamecocks of Jacksonville State and the Eagles of Tennessee Tech, both looking to advance to the top spots of the conference standings. Our game of the week, however, is the match between number 3 Eastern Kentucky and the number 2 Belmont Bruins. The Colonels host the Bruins, both looking for a W that will potentially be big changes in the conference standings. That, along with all other conference matchups, can be found on the OVC Digital Network. Turning to football, be sure to tune into ESPN3 as the top 2 scoring defenses in the OVC square off at LP Field in Nashville, Tennessee. Watch the Tigers of Tennessee State try to regain momentum as they take on the Eastern Kentucky Colonels, who have only lost once this season. All other conference matchups can be found this Saturday on the OVC Digital Network. Coming up now are my top plays from around the OVC this week. So let's get straight into it. Let's go.
Holding down the number 5 spot in this week's countdown is Murray and SIUE. Look at this nice rally they have going here to end the first set. But Murray ends up winning this set and the rest to come. But first, Taylor Odom delivers a message. Check this out. Delivers it right to the SIUE defender. Watch out. Number 4 comes in from EKU. Freshman Logan Harvey finds the back of the net, bending one past the EIU goalie. That's in the 7th minute of extra time. Way to contribute, freshman. Number 3. Shout out to the whole Murray State special teams. This one comes from DeQuavius Walker. Returns the first play of the game. Kickoff. Takes him 10 seconds to get to the end zone. Oh, let me get some of this action, he says. Can't touch me. Loses his towel and finds the back of the end zone. And Harris says, don't forget about me. Let me get in on some of this action as well. But check this out. Runs over a few defenders, keeps his balance, and finds the back of the end zone. Shout out to the whole Murray State Racers. They put up a school record, 85 points. At number 2, we have a quarterback wide receiver hookup. Comes from Tennessee Tech. Check this catch out. Darian Stone links up with Brock McCoy. Yes, over 2 defenders, keeps his balance, catch. Holding down your top spot for the week comes from EKU, Jared McClain, and Devin Borders. Check this catch out. Leaps over defender and walks into the end zone.
If you think you have a top play nominee, remember to submit it to us here at the OVC office. We will look at it, and you just might make my top 5 countdown. As with every episode of Overtime, we like to salute a different student athlete for their efforts in their particular sport. This week's OVC honors goes to Southeast Missouri's Jenna Collinridge. Collinridge is a junior midfielder from Wales, Australia. She has contributed a lot on the pitch in her first 2 years at SEMO, but reached a milestone in her career, scoring her first 2 goals in SEMO's victory over Jacksonville State this past week, and looks to do much more in the season's defining game Friday against the Cougars of SIUE. Congratulations, Jenna, and good luck this weekend, because you are the OVC honoree of the week. Thank you for tuning in to another episode of Overtime with the OVC. Keeping in mind this weekend, athletes, that winners never quit and quitters never win. That is a food for thought for all you cross-country athletes this weekend competing in those mile races. I'm Jonathan Owens. See you next time on Overtime with the OVC.